亲爱的弟兄姐妹、朋友们，平安！我是桥梁教会的小白，欢迎您参加今天的主日敬拜。首先，让我们一起低头祷告。亲爱的天父，我们再次谦卑地来到你面前，摇动你大能的手，向你祷告和呼求。感恩节和圣诞节马上来临，这史上前所未有的一年就要临近尾声。在这感恩的季节里，求主帮助我们定睛在主身上，细细数算神的恩典。求神保守在抗疫一线的医护人员，保守每一位弟兄姐妹、慕道友和他们的家人，保守他们身心平安，带领他们更多认识、信靠和跟随主。每个人、每个家庭的各样困难和需要，主你都知道。愿神的恩典和祝福丰丰富富地加给众人。求主祝福以下的时间，让讲员的信息合神的心意。求圣灵在每个人心里动工，让我们听到并且明白神的话语。以上祷告是奉主耶稣基督的名，阿们。现在让我们一起用一颗感恩的心，用心灵和诚实一起来敬拜我们的神。
在神的国度里，有权柄和能力，不凭血气，不凭势力，单单依靠主圣灵。在神的国度里，属神的子民，不分语言，在你面前将荣耀归于你。主耶稣的生命，愿你圣灵彰显在这地，施行神迹医治能力，我们伫立在你的同在里。主圣灵，在神的国度里，属神的子民，不分语言，在你面前将荣耀归于你。愿你国度降临在这里，同心高举主耶稣圣灵，愿你圣灵彰显在这里。 稣，愿你国度降临在这地，同心高举主耶稣的
Good morning, dear friends, and greetings from Turlock.
早安，各位弟兄姐妹，我是从 Turlock 向你们问安。
I wish I could talk to you in person, but we will use technology to help us out.
我希望能亲身到你们中间跟你们讲道，但是现在我们只好用高科技的方式在云端来跟你们讲道。
And we're all waiting for the day whenWe can see each other face to face.
我们等不及那一天来到，就是我们可以面对面的再见面。
We have come to the end of the Sermon on the Mount in our study together.
我们已经来到登山宝训的最后的一段。
And Jesus had been primarily calling his disciples to teach them.
耶稣基督主要是把他的门徒召集以来跟他们教导。
And of course, there were some other followers that had listened to it too, as Jesus was presenting the principles of the kingdom of God.
当然也有其他的人跟从的人来听，耶稣就向他们说天国的标准。
But during this long sermon, Matthew 5, 6, and 7, many other people had also gathered.
当这个很长的讲到从第五章到第七章有很多人慢慢也在跟着聚集来听。
And that number had grown substantially. There was a vast crowd there now.
那个群众的越来越多。
Why did this happen?
为什么会这样子呢?
The last verse in this chapter, chapter 7, tells us why it happened.
马太福音第七章二十九节最后一节这样说
It says, he taught as one who had authority and not as their teachers of the law.
因为他教训他们正像有权柄的人不像他们的文士
You know, when Jesus spoke, he spoke with authority, he spoke with power.
当耶稣讲道的时候他是有权柄的
He spoke because he had the truth.
他讲到是因为他讲的是真理。
And when a person can speak with the authority of truth, people will listen.
当一个人能够用真理的权柄来讲的时候，人就会听。
Jesus had laid out God's standards for our lives that differed greatly from man-made rules and regulations.
耶稣教导他们有关上帝对我们生活的标准与他们的宗教领袖所定的人为的规则有很大的分别。
And now he lays before us two ways of how we can really respond to that message.
他放在我们面前有两条路，我们怎么样可以对这个讲道有反应。
He said there was a wide gate and then there was a narrow gate.
他说有一个宽的门，有一个窄的门。
He said there was a broad road and there was a narrow road.
他说有一条是宽的路，有一条是窄的路。
But then Jesus had warned them and said there are only few that will find it.
但是耶稣是提醒他们，只有很少数人能够找到那条对的路。
You see, the Christian life...is not based on what we think and on our judgment.
基督徒的生命并不是基于我们的判断或是我们的想法是什么。
It is based on what God says and whether we respond in obedience to Him.
乃是基于我们对神话语的绝对顺从。
That is the road that leads to life.
这就是这条路可以带到一个生命的路。
But unfortunately, there are many people, when they have to make that choice, they do not want to follow that rule.
很不幸，有很多人在选择的时候，他不愿意跟从这个的这个方法。
Because man rejects the authority of God.
因为人拒绝神的权柄。
Man chooses his own way.
人选择自己的道路。
And Jesus says, that road leads to destruction.
耶稣告诉他们说，这条路带来是引到灭亡。
Now, if you have Bibles, I want you to turn with me to Matthew chapter 7.
如果你有圣经的话，我请你翻开马太福音第七章。
And we'll begin with verse 15.
我们从十五节开始。
And we'll find out what Jesus says as he comes to the conclusion of the Sermon on the Mount.
我们来看看耶稣在这个登山宝训的最后的结语是什么。
This first section deals with warning that Jesus gives about true and false prophets.
第一段呢，他耶稣提醒、警告他们要提防假先知和假老师。
Let's look at verse 15. Let me read for you.
我们先来看第十五节，让我读给你们听。你们要防备假先知。What?他们到你这里来，外面披着羊皮，里面却是残暴的狼。
And then we'll go to verse 16, all the way through to verse 20.
好，然后我们再读16节到20节。凭着他们的果子就可以认出他们来。荆棘上岂能摘葡萄呢？棘藜里岂能摘无花果呢？这样，凡好树都结好果子，唯独坏树结坏果子。好树不能结好坏果子，坏树不能结好果子。凡不结好果子的树，就砍下来丢在火里。所以，凭着他们的果子就可以认出他们来。
Here Jesus gives a very strong warning against false prophets and teachers.Whose intended is to deceive the people.
这里耶稣给他们一个非常强力的提醒警告，要他们提防假先知和假教师，因为这些人故意要欺骗他们，要把他们带偏离的正路。
Now, false prophets, they were nothing new to the people of Israel.
对于以色列人来说，假先知是并不是稀奇的，不是新的。
When you read the Old Testament, you read again and again about false prophets that came.
你读旧约的时候就看到他们非常多的假先知的出现。
You see, God has his own true prophets, but Satan also has false prophets.
正如神有他自己的真的先知，那撒旦也有他们的假先知。
And we must be very careful that we recognize these false prophets when they come.
我们也非常小心，当他们来到的时候，我们能够分辨。
See, from their outward appearance, they look very legitimate, very attractive, and often very powerful.
外表看起来他们是非常正派的，甚至是非常吸引人的甚至能够非常有能力。
But Jesus says,Inwardly, they are just like ferocious wolves.
但是耶稣说他们里面是像一个残暴的狼一样。
And we must be very careful when they come and infiltrate our lives and lead us astray.
我们很小心当他们来到的时候，提防他们渗透了我们的生命，把我们带离的正途。
You know, we have that saying,that perception is not reality.
我们不想听过，就是说观念并不是事实。
See, things are often not what they appear to be.
很多事情不像外表看起来那样。
And in Matthew 24, towards the final days of Jesus' ministry, he warned his disciples that the end times would be marked by deception.
在马太福音24章，就是耶稣的传道的最后的时期，他提醒他的门徒说，在末世的时候，有很多迷惑人的事情来发生。
In fact, Jesus says that many will be deceived.
事实上，而且很多人因为这样子受迷惑。
But here he gives a very strong warning that we need to watch out.
耶稣在这里给我们非常严重的提醒，叫我们要提防。
But he also tells us how can we be protected from these false prophets.
同时他也告诉我们怎么样可以保护我们不受欺骗。
So he asks a question here, how can you tell a false prophet?
这里他问一个问题，你怎么样可以分辨他是真还是假的先知呢？
And then Jesus gives the answer.
那耶稣就给我们一个答案。
He says, you will know them by their fruits.
耶稣说你可以从他们的果子行为就可以知道他们。
See, outwardly they might appear wonderful people, but inwardly they are not, and their life will end up as a fruitless life.
他们外表可能是一个非常好的人，但是他们里面可能是一个非常没有果子的，不结果子的人生。
And Jesus was always very practical when he taught the people.
耶稣基督对人讲道时常常能够就地取材。
And his teaching was always what people knew, and then taught them something additional.
他用他们熟悉的事物来讲述他自己的讲的教训。
And here he uses an example from agriculture.
这里他用那个农业的一个例子来跟我们说明。
Now, if Jesus had lived today, he probably would have used illustrations from technology or from computers.
如果在今天的话，耶稣可能就会用高科技里面的名词或是电脑来跟我们说明。
So here he talked about trees.
这里他谈到树。
These were fruit-bearing trees.
这是结果子的树。
Now, what is the purpose of a fruit-bearing tree? It is to produce fruit.
果树它们的生命是主要目的就是要结果子。
And he says, if they don't bear fruit, you cut down that tree.
如果它们不结果子的话，你就把它砍下来。
And so what he says here, that false teachers may appear attractive from the outside, but what comes from the inside,is what really counts.
所以假先知外表看起来是非常的吸引人，但是他们的里面才是最重要的。
Their character, their lifestyle, their theology will eventually betray them.
他们的行为，他们的个性，甚至他们的神学观念，就会把他们显露出来。
They might be very eloquent speakers.
他可能是一个雄才厚论，能够口才很好的讲员。
And they might attract many, many people to come and listen to them.
他们可能能够吸引很多人来听他们讲说，跟从他。
In fact, they might even produce miracles.
他们甚至能够行神迹。
And demonstrate some very unusual powers.
能够显示他们一个很奇特的异能。
But you know, the Apostle Paul says in 2 Corinthians 11,that Satan himself masquerades as an angel of light, and his servants masquerade as servants of righteousness.
保罗在哥林多后书十一章十四节到十五节这样说，这也不足为怪，因为连撒旦也装作光明的天使，所以他的差役若装作仁义的差役也不算为稀奇。
See, these people follow that broad way that leads to destruction.
这些人就是选择那条宽的路引到灭亡的。
And so Jesus says, by their fruits, they will be revealed, you will know them.
所以耶稣说，凭着他们的果子，你就可以认出他们来。
You see, they might call themselves Christians.
他们可能是称他们自己为基督徒。
But in reality, they have never submitted themselves to the authority of Jesus Christ.
但事实上，他们从来没有把他们生命交给神，让耶稣基督来管理。
And so Jesus says here in verse 21, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father who is in heaven.
所以在七章二十一节这样说，凡称呼我主啊、主啊的人，不能都进天国，唯独遵行我天父旨意的人才能进去。
And therefore,obedience to the word of God is always the keystone to authentic Christian living.
所以一个人能够遵守神的话语的话，才是他们是真正基督徒的一个标示。
So Jesus has talked about false prophets, and then he has talked about also false disciples.
他讲到假先知，他也讲到假的使徒。
And we need to be very careful to realize that many who call themselves believers are really not believers.
所以我们自己也很小心，很多人他们自称为信徒，却不是相信的人。
Going to church doesn't make you a real Christian.
你去教会不能让你成为真正的基督徒。
It is only those who invite Christ to be the one that gives them absolute direction in their lives.
只有那些是跟从耶稣给他的那个话语去遵行的才是。
And then Jesus comes to a final illustration.
最后耶稣讲到他最后的讲论。
And we'll look at that in Matthew chapter 7, 24 to 28.
这就是马太福音七章二十三节到二十七节。
Let's read this.
好，我们就来读。所以，凡听见我这话去行的，好比一个聪明人，把房子盖在磐石上。雨淋、水冲、风吹，撞着那房子，房子总不倒塌，因为根基立在磐石上。凡听见我这话不去行的，好比一个无知的人，把房子盖在沙土上。雨淋、水冲、风吹，撞着那房子，房子就倒塌了，并且倒塌得很大。
So the Sermon on the Mount closes with this final illustration.
登山宝训以这个比喻来结束。
There were two builders.
有两个建造房子的人。
And Jesus calls one of them a wise builder and the other one a foolish builder.
耶稣称一个是聪明的，另外一个是愚拙的人。
See, Jesus is still talking about people having a choice.To go either his way or their own way.
耶稣在这里仍然是告诉他的听众说，你可以有选择，是要选择神的道路还是自己的道路。
And now he gives them clear instruction of what they need to do in order to follow that narrow way that leads to life.
耶稣在这里给他们很清楚的指示，怎么样才可以跟随那个窄路，直到他可以到天国，神的国。
And see, Jesus not only warns us, but he gives us instruction. He tells us what to do.
耶稣不但是提醒我们，他还给我们很详细的指示，该怎么样去做。
I believe that there are many of us living in our world today who are very discouraged.
我相信我们今天活在生活当中是很多都非常丧气的，灰心。
All the circumstances that we have been facing lately have presented some real difficulties in our lives.
我们所面对的很多的境况是令我们 面对生命中很多的困境。
And many people wonder what is really their belief system. There are a lot of doubts in their minds.
有人甚至是怀疑他们的信仰，他们是说这个信仰有什么用？
And especially among young people, we find there's been a lot of depression, and often this has increased that has often ended up in suicide.
尤其是在年轻的一群里面，他们常常有很多的忧虑，因为他们不知道该怎么做，以至于他们最后以自杀来结束他们的生命。
They just see no way out. They see no future ahead of them.
他们看不到任何的出路，也看不到他们的将来。
And this is exactly the time when the gospel, the good news of Jesus, becomes a very relevant thing in our lives.
正因为这样，今天耶稣的信实是那么的重要。
See, Jesus tells us that God's word provides us with a choice, a way out of our problems.
神的耶稣的话语给了我们有一个选择，也给我们了一条出路。
And so here again, Jesus uses an everyday illustration.
再次耶稣用他们日常生活的一些的事情来做说明。
He talks about two builders.
他谈到两个建造房子的人。
One is called a wise builder, and the other one is a foolish builder.
一个是聪明的，另外一个是愚拙的。
Let's take a look at them.
让我们来看看他们。
There are four things that they share in common.
他们有四样的事情是相同的。
Both builders have heard the message of Jesus.
这两个建造房子的人都是听到神的话语的。
Because Jesus says, everyone who hears these words of mine,
因为耶稣说凡听见我这话的人
So both of the builders had heard what God wanted them to do.
这两个建造房子的人都听到耶稣告诉他们该如何实行。
Point number two is they both build houses after they've heard the message.
他们两个人都是在听完耶稣基督的信息以后去建房子的。
Number three,They both build houses in the same general area because both were affected by the same weather conditions and rainstorms.
第三点是他们都是在相同的地区建造房子，也当然是受到同样天气的影响跟暴风雨的影响。
And number four, their houses were basically alike.From all outward appearances, there was no difference.
第四点就是他们的房子在外表看起来完全一模一样，没有什么分别。
So those were the two builders.
这就是这两个的建造的人。
But one is called wise, and the other one is called foolish.
但是一个人是被称为是有智慧的，另外一个是愚拙的。
Now, what was the basic difference?Between these two houses.
那但两个人当中有什么基本 的不同呢?
What was it?
那是什么呢?
It was the foundation on which they were built.
是关于他们是在什么的根基上面来建造。
From the outward appearances, they were all the same.
外表看起来这个房子一模一样。
But...Here was something very, very important that was different.
但是这里有一个非常重要的，也是非常不一样的。
Their foundation was not the same.
就是他们的根基不一样。
One acted in obedience to God's word, and the other one did not.
一个是遵行神的话语，另外一个没有。
It says the wise one, he heard what God was saying to him, and he put it into practice, he obeyed.
讲到那个有智慧的人是听到了神的话语，他就照着去行了。
The other one heard it also, but it says he did not listen to God, he disobeyed God, he did not put it into practice.
另外一个人也听到神的教训了，但是他不把他当作一回事，他不服从神的话语。
You see, the wise builder, he built on the specifications that God had given to him.
那个聪明的就是按着神的指示去建造。
But the foolish one, he disobeyed God, he built it on his own human ideas.
另外一个呢，他不按照神的话语，他按照他自己的想法去做。
And Jesus tells us in this story that he gives us, the wise men built upon the rock, the other one built on a foundation of sand.
耶稣在这里指出，那个聪明的人是把他的房子建造在磐石上面，而那个愚拙的是建造在沙土上。
Now, when the storms came,
当风暴风雨来到的时候，
the house that was built on the rock remained firm.
当风雨来到时候，那个建造在磐石上的房子依然坚固站立。
But the house that was built on sand fell with a great crash.
但那建造在沙土上的房子倒塌了，而且倒塌很大。
Jesus used this illustration to present a spiritual truth that is so important for us to grasp.
耶稣用这个例子来是要表明一个非常重要的属灵的信息，希望我们可以能够抓住的。
And I want to share with you how we can apply this truth in our own lives.
我想跟你们分享我们怎么样在我们的生活上面能够实行出来。
What does this message mean to us personally? How do we apply it?
这个信息对我个人来说有什么的意义？我怎么样应用在我的生命上？
You see, whenever the word of God is presented and proclaimed, we must also find out what we are going to do with it.
当我们每一次听到或是看到神的教训的时候，我们就要想怎么样可以应用到我们的生命当中。
I have said this before, but I'll repeat it again.
我前面已经讲过了，我再次重复一遍。
The great American evangelist Dwight L. Moody once said something like this.
最伟大的布道家穆迪先生曾经这样说过。
He said, the word of God was not primarily given to us to increase our knowledge, but to change our way of living.
他说神把他的话语给我们，不是叫我们有更多的知识，而是希望借着他可以改变我们的生活。
Let me repeat that.
让我再次重复一遍。
The word of God was not given us so we have more knowledge.
神的话语给我们并不是增加我们的知识而已。
So we have more facts, more information.
会得到更多的资讯或是事实。
The word of God was given to change the way we live and to do it in a way that is in obedience to God.
他给我们觉得话语是让我们能够顺服，能够改变我们的生活。
So what do you need to take home from this message that Jesus is giving?
你从这个信息里面你能够得到什么的教训呢？
Here it is. Listen very carefully.
好，你请仔细听听。
You need to have a root system in your life to sustain you in times of trouble.
你在你的生命当中需要一个非常坚固的根基，使你在生命的逆境当中的时候可以站立得住。
You need a root system that anchors you firmly so that your house will not fall.
你需要你生命的一个根部的组织，让你能够紧紧地抓住你土地，可以在风雨的时候站立得稳。
This is what Jesus had in mind when he told the story about the two builders.
当耶稣讲这个两个建造房子的故事的时候，他是这样想的。
One built on a strong foundation, and his house was able to resist and overcome even when there were big storms in his life.
他说那个把房子建造在坚固磐石上的人，当风雨来到的时候，他房子不但能够抵挡得住，而且能够站立胜过。
The other one built on sand, and his house crumbled Because he did not have a root system, he had no foundation.
另外一个建造在沙土上面，当风雨来的时候，他没有一个很坚固、很健全的根部组织，以至于他的房子会倒塌。
See, storms in life are inevitable.
我们知道啊，风暴在的生命当中是在所难免的。
I think all will agree about this statement.
我相信你们大家都同意这句话。
And the year 2020 has been a year in which we all have been affected by this.
2020年就是一年我们每个人都受到这个风暴的影响。
Of course, there was COVID-19.
首先是新冠病情。
A horrendous storm which not only struck our country, but almost every region of the world.
这个可怕的疫情不但是打击了我们的国家，甚至影响到世界每一个角落。
It affected us physically and caused the death of thousands of people.
它影响到我们的健康，使许多千千万万的人失去他们生命。
Perhaps we have had friends or family members who died as a result of that.
可能我们认识的人或是有些的家人是因为这个冠状新冠疫情而失去生命的。
So besides that storm, we also had an economic storm.
除此以外，我们还有经济的风暴。
People lost their jobs, their businesses were bankrupt, and there were financial wipeouts to many, many people.
除了这个还带来经济上面的风暴，许许多多人失去他们的工作，他们可能会破产，甚至他们的经济全部被一扫而空。
And then, let's not forget, we had these firestorms here in California and throughout the western states.
我们还不要忘记，在我们加州的山火，还有美国西岸的所有的州。
People lost their homes and their basic way of living.
许多人失去他们的家园，失去他们正常的生活所需。
And then there were the hurricanes that were in the southwestern United States.
接着在中国的西南部还有龙卷风。
And then, of course, the political storms that about the presidential elections.
当然还有是因为今年大选引起来的政治风暴。
You know, we could go on and on about all of these adversities and storms that came into our lives this year alone.
你是可以看看，我们还可以说出很多今年在发生在我们身上的不易逆境跟疫的风暴。
And my question to you today is, how did you cope with these storms and other personal storms this past year?
我想问你一个问题，面对这些的风暴，还有你个人的风暴，你怎么面对呢？
Perhaps there was sickness, because maybe there were accidents, maybe there were strained family relationships that came upon you.
可能有人是因为疾病，有人是因为意外，还有一些可能是家庭关系的破裂等等。
How did you deal with those kind of storms in your life?
你如何面对你生命中这些风暴呢？
What kind of a root system did you have?
你的生命当中有什么的根部的结构呢？组织呢？
Did you have a firm foundation?
你是不是有一个很坚固的根基？
Or did your house crumble during these storms?
还是你的房子在这些的风暴当中倒塌了？
Well, these are very tough questions.
知道这是很难回答的。
But the scripture, the Bible, gives us a very clear perspective.
但是我们圣经给我们非常清楚的观念。
Many years ago, I memorized a verse that I often think aboutAs we go through these storms.
在好多年前我背诵了一节的经文，在今年面对这些的人生风暴的时候，给我很大的帮助。
It's in Isaiah chapter 33, verse 6.
是记载在以赛亚书33章第六节，我把它念出来。
And it might be good if you could write down that reference so you could look it up when you get home.
如果你能够把它写下来、记下来，回家再重复看看的话，对你非常有帮助。
It says he will be the sure foundation for your times, a rich store of salvation, wisdom, and knowledge, and the fear of the Lord is the key to this treasure.
这里说，你一生一世必得安稳，有丰盛的救恩，并智慧和知识。你以敬畏耶和华为至宝。
In this story about the builders, Jesus illustrates the importance of having a sure foundation.
在这个建造房子的这个故事里面，耶稣阐明是说，我们有一个坚固的根基是何等重要。
He talks about building on a rock or building on sand.
他谈到是说，你是建造在磐石上还是在沙土上。
Now I believe that the rock that's spoken of here is God's word.
我相信这里所说的磐石就是神的话语。
The builder is the one, the wise builder is the one who builds on a foundation of listening and acting in obedience to God's word.
那个有聪明的建造的人是把他的房子、生命建造在神的话语并且是遵行上面。
So building on a rock really is the same thing as obeying God's word.
所以如果你把房子建造在磐石上，就等于是你遵行神的话语。
Now the person who builds on sand is the one who might follow religious traditions and have an appearance of godliness.
他们建造在房子建造在沙土上面，就像他们外表是跟着一些的宗教的传统而好像很虔诚。
But there's no spiritual life, there's no power in there because he has built on sand.
但是他们没有属灵的实质，因为他们的生命的根基建造在沙土上。
They have ignored the word of God.
他们轻视了神的话语。
You see, there are many people thatOutwardly call themselves Christians, but inwardly their lifestyle betrays them.
你知道吗？有些人外表他称他们是基督徒，但是他们的生活方式出卖显露了他们的真相。
Their lifestyle has never changed. It's the same as it has always been.
他们的生活从来就没有改变过，跟以前一样。
They follow their own value system and not God's.
他们是根据自己的价值观来行，而不是神的。
And the Bible calls this is building on sand.
圣经称呼这些人是把房子建造在沙土上的人。
And when the storms of life come, they will collapse.
当生命的风暴来到的时候，他们这个房子会倒塌。
So now the question is, how do you build on that rock?
问题又来了，我们怎么样才能把我们的生命建造在这个磐石上呢？
I've already mentioned that the rock that this refers to is the word of God. God and his word can be trusted.
我前面已经提过了，这个根基，这个磐石就是神的话语，而且这个话语是值得我们信任的。
The true mark of a disciple, of a follower of Jesus, is not simplyhearing and believing God's word.
一个真正的是一个跟从耶稣的信徒的指示表示不是他们听了神的话语而相信而已。
It is believing and doing it.
而是接受相信了而实行在生活上。
See, the test of a true disciple is not one who knows, who hears and believes, but one who practices it.
那个试验呢，不是说你知道多少，你听了多少而相信，而是你遵行。
Jesus said in John 14:21, "Whoever has my commandments and obeys them, He is the one who loves me.
耶稣在约翰福音14:21这样说，有了我的命令也又遵守的，这人是爱我的。
So therefore it's important that we know his commands, isn't it?
所以是我们要能够明白他的命令是很重要的。
And so how do you know what his commands are so that you can obey them?
那我们怎么知道他的命令是什么，好叫我们可以去遵行呢？
Now the answer is very simple.
答案是非常的简单。
Take time that you spend in reading and incorporating God's word into your life.
花时间好好读神的话语，而将它实行在你的生命当中。
And if you do this, it will establish not only a foundation, but a strong root system.
如果你能这样做，不但是能够是建在一个好的根基，而且是一个非常健全的根部组织。
And then when the storms of life come,
当生命的风暴来到的时候,
you can remain firmly grounded.
你就可以站立得稳。
In the first Psalm, we have a very clear description of that.
在诗篇第一篇的时候有一个非常的清楚的说明。
It talks about a godly man and woman.
他讲到一个敬畏神的人。
Verses 2 and 3 say, His delight is in the law of the Lord, and on His law He meditates day and night. He's like a tree planted by the streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, and whose leaf does not wither, and whatever He does prospers.
第二到第三节这样说，唯喜爱耶和华的律法，昼夜思想的人，这人变为有福。他要像一棵栽在溪，一棵树栽在溪水旁，按时候结果子，叶子也不枯干。凡他所做的，尽都顺利。
Do you have a rock in your life?
你的生命当中有一个磐石吗？
Is there something that will keep you firm and strong when these adversities and those hurricanes come into your life?
当生命的逆境风暴跟龙卷风来到的时候，你是否能够强壮而且稳固站立得稳？
You know, as I was thinking about this message, I was asking the Lord to give me an illustration.
当我在思想这一个经文的时候，求神给我智慧。
Lord, I said,Give me a story, something that I can communicate to show how this works.
神给我一个故事，让我可以把这个教训阐明出来。
You know, when we pray, God always answers.
你知道吗？当我们祷告的时候，神常常回答我们。
He sometimes does it in a different way than we expect.
他常常是有时候他不是用我们想的方法来回应我们。
A couple of days ago, we were finishing our last preparations before going to bed.
几天前，当我们准备处理好一切正要上床的时候。
You know, I'm a little bit faster than my wife, and so I was already in bed.
我常常比我太太快一点，所以我已经上了床。
And after a while, she came over to the bed.
过了一阵子，她来到床边。
And all of a sudden, she collapsed.
忽然之间，她突然倒下来了。
And I quickly ran out to her side of the bed and to help her into bed.
所以我马上跳起来，就把她扶到床边，让她躺下来。
And she was all confused.
然后她完全就是完全混乱了。
She said, "Where are we?"
他是说我们在哪里
？Who are you? What are you doing?
他说你是谁？你在做什么
？And so I began to ask her some questions, and she was totally confused.
当我问他一项的问题，他完全非常混乱，不晓得怎么回答。
Later on, we found that her blood pressure was really going up very high.
到后来，我们才发现原来他的血压突然飙得很高。
So I called 911.
于是我就打911。
And within about 7 minutes, they came in through my front door.
7分钟他们就来到了。
they came and tried to figure out what the problem was.
他们来到要看看情况是怎么样。
And then two nurses came with an ambulance.
接着有两个护士跟着这个救护车来到。
And they took her blood pressure.
他们量了她的血压。
And they tried to engage her in conversation.
然后要试着要跟她沟通谈话。
And they were afraid that she had had a stroke.
他们很害怕她是一个中风。
So they said, we need to take her immediately to the hospital.
于是他们说我们马上要把她送到医院里面去。
And I said, can I follow you?
我问我可以跟你们去吗？
They said, no, because of COVID, maybe you can't even go in and see her.
不行，因为是新冠病状的那个疫情，你可能根本也不能进去看她。
They said, call the hospital in an hour or two to see whether you can go.
你要过一两个小时以后，你可以打电话到医院问，看看你可不可以进去看她。
And so they left.
于是他们就走了。
I was all alone at home.
我自己一个人在家中。
That was a storm.
这就是一个人生的风暴。
And this is where foundation is so important.
那就是说我们的根基是何等重要。
A few days before I had memorized another verse of scripture.
在几天前我曾经又背诵了另一节的经文。
It came from Isaiah chapter 41, verse 13.
就是记载在以赛亚书41章第13节。
And there God gives us a wonderful promise.
在那里神给我一个奇妙的应许。
Let me quote it for you.
让我来读给你们听。
For I am the Lord your God who takes hold of your right hand and says to you,Do not fear, I will help you.
读给你听，因为我耶和华你的神必裁乎你的右手，对你说，不要害怕，我必帮助你。
You know, the first thought that came to me when Alice left the house and I was all alone, what is going to happen to her?
当我太太被带走以后，我一个人在家中，那个时候我想，我该做什么？
Will I see her alive again?
我能否再看到她恢复过来呢？
I was afraid.
我害怕。
And then God gave me this verse.
接着神就是把这个经文给我。
I am the Lord your God.
他是说我是你的主耶和华。
And I'm taking your right hand.
我现在是缠着你的右手。
And I'm saying to you, don't be afraid.
我现在对你说不要害怕。
Because I'm going to help you.
因为我要帮助你。
And you know, my fear totally left me.
你知道吗？那个时候我的害怕完全就没有了。
I was at peace.
我马上心里面觉得很平安。
Because God said he would help me.
因为神说他会帮我。
Later on, my daughter whom I had called, she said, Dad, you were so calm.
他接着他那个女儿打电话来跟他说爸爸你是非常的平静。
And I said, I'll tell you why.
那我跟他说，我跟你说是为什么。
See, when our foundation is strong, God will always keep his promises.
你知道吗？当你我们的根基是稳固的时候，神必定会遵守他的应许。
And what was that rock on which I was building?
我是在什么的磐石上面来建造呢？
It was the word of God.
就是神的话语上。
And that brought peace into my life.
就是这个神的话语给我的生命带来平安。
So today I'm calling on you to make a fresh commitment to spend time getting into the word of God.
我今天呼吁你重新在神面前立志。
If you do not have a reading plan, develop a reading plan for your scripture reading.
你要花时间好好读神的话语。如果你没有一个很好的读经计划来建立一个。
Begin reading the New Testament.
你可以从新约开始读。
And even start jotting down some things that you're learning.
当你读的时候，甚至可以记下一些你学到的功课。
Maybe there's a promise that you discover that God is giving to you.
或许在这个经文里面，神给了你一个应许，你可以抓住它。
Maybe there's a new command or a challenge that he gives to you.
或许是一个命令或是一个挑战，神给你的。
Or maybe there's some new truth that you're discovering.
或许你发现新的真理。
Write it down so you can share it with somebody, and God will allow that root system to grow in your life.
你记下来跟别人分享，神就容许你记的根部能够往下扎根。
And this will help you grow and stand firm in times of trouble.
如果你能够这样子做的话，在你这个生命的风暴当中，你就可以成长，而且也能够坚固。
Because you're building on a rock.
因为你的根基是在磐石上。
I need to finish the story about Alice.
我要讲完我太太的故事。
She was in the hospital only 12 hours.
她只在医院逗留了12个小时。
And then I could pick her up and bring her home.
然后我就可以把她接回家中。
And now she needs to make some adjustments, but we thank God that he spared her life.
她当然生活上面有需要一些的调整，但是我们感谢神救了她的命。
It was not a stroke, it was a TIA, and so we're grateful for that.
不是一个真正的中风，是一个短歇的那个血管那个血液的那个阻塞。
Thank you for your prayers for us.
谢谢你们为我们祷告。
And as I finish this message, I want to pray for you too.
在我结束这个信息以前，我要为你来祷告。
Lord, thank you that you love us deeply.
感谢神，你这样的爱我们深深的。
And you want us to find that narrow path that leads to life.
你要我们找到那条窄的路是通到生命的。
And Lord, we pray that today you will open our eyes to surrender ourselves to you.
主啊，开我们的眼睛，让我们的生命能够完全的降服于你。
So that we can enjoy all the blessings that you have for us as we obey you.
让我们可以因着顺服你自己的话语而得到你所有的祝福。
Bless each of our brothers and sisters as they hear this message.
祝福每一位听到这个信息的弟兄姐妹。
And grant them that they will build on a sound, firm foundation.
让他们能够在你里面建造一个坚固的根基。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名求。
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you richly.
愿神大大的祝福你们。